All right, Michelle Glass here, and our job for today is to finish up the skull finally by labeling the four suture lines and then four fontanelles on the foetal skull. So to begin, look at your model so you're facing the front of the model, and you can see our first suture line is called the coronal suture. The coronal suture is going to be the joint where the frontal bone connects in with the parietal bones, and then to some extent you can see over here near where the sphenoid bone would be. So that is the coronal suture. The suture line that is separating the left and right parietal bones is called the sagittal suture, and it is in the sagittal plane, so that's how it's getting its name. You have a suture line at the back of the skull separating or joining the occipital bones with the parietal bones. This one looks sort of like an upside down V. That is the lambdoid or lambdoidal suture. The term lambda is a Greek letter that looks like an upside down V. And then you have squamous sutures, where the temporal bone is joining in with the parietal and the sphenoid bone here. So you have a left and right squamous suture. That's of course named because we are here at the squamous part of the temporal bone. Now what we will see is that those suture lines are the joints where these bones come together. And in the foetal skull, we will see that these are not fully formed. You don't have bone connecting to bone at that point yet. You still have some cartilage in between, what we call soft spots, or more technically fontanelles. And we have, I think, four fontanelles that we're naming on the foetal skull. And so that's this model that we have here. You'll see that these fontanelles are remaining in place until the child is reaching about age two, and then you see them finally closing. The first fontanelle that we can name here is the anterior fontanelle. So here you see the anterior or the frontal fontanelle, where the frontal bones and the parietal bones are coming together. That's the biggest and the one you probably have already seen before. At the back of the skull, we have the posterior fontanelle. So that's going to be where the parietal and occipital bones come together. And then we have two on the side. So we do have four. We have the mastoid fontanelle. So you're not seeing a well-defined mastoid process yet in the fetus. Let's see if I can get it closer. So right in here. So basically that's going to be where you have the parietal, temporal, and occipital bones coming together. And then right here, you have this sphenoidal fontanelle, and so that's going to be where the frontal, parietal, temporal, and sphenoid bones come together. And so you're going to have a left and right for both the sphenoidal and the mastoid fontanelles. That's it.